Bonjour. Comment estás?
Ni hao.
So today we are going to learn how to, I'm going to show you. I'm not sure if you can learn or not. I'm going to show you how to push back an aircraft. Today we're going to start out with a 737-800. Right now I'm hooking up the tow bar. This is just a simple latch and connect, and also have to put a red pin in to hold the axle, so when we push back it doesn't break or anything. And I'm about to get that pin right now. Here's the pin. It's technically called a bypass pin. So as soon as you get ready to push, you need to have this pin in. On this particular aircraft, I know the Airbus, it just varies, depends aircraft to aircraft. So we are going to latch this on.
Yes, sir.
Just give us one more minute, sir. All right, so here's what the deal is. We have the headset communicating. Give us a couple more minutes to do a walk around. We're going to do a checklist to make sure everything's in place. Then we have a neutral reserves for parking brake. From there, we'll remove the chunks. And if y'all remember the movie Cars, you turn left to go right, you turn right to go left.
So, path clear, number set, doors closed, walk around done, dead bridge, stove, JC disconnected, let's go pull chunks.
So from there, we're pulling the chunks now. We're gonna call up to the cockpit flight deck. So ground the flight deck, ramp the cockpit or something, whatever you need to say. And you're gonna say, all right, we're ready to go. And they'll be like, all right, stand by, let's do their checklist. And then they're gonna release their brake, turn the beacon on, and then from there, you can start pushing. Once they get ATC clearance, and ask them what room they want. Alright, we're on the flight deck. We're ready, sir. Come on, sir.
Well, the reason for turning an airplane sometimes, in some areas you have to, some states you have to turn an airplane. It's just mandatory because they can't maneuver. It also just makes the pilots less nervous when you can put them in a place and they can easily see where they're going. But some of them get a little bit nervous turning where they can't really see because you can't see the wings. It's not like you can look when you're driving a car, you can look outside and out the window or in your mirror and see the back of your car or the rear of the car. They just have that probably maybe a 60 or 70 degree view of the sides. So they maybe see, they even see heroes back, but then that's leaning your head out the window or whatever. So it's easier for both parties, and also you don't get you control where the jet blast is gonna go. If you just push the plane any kind of way, it'll turn around and the jet blast will just blast in your face, all that. It's just terrible.
So yeah. So and what, who is it? Doc from Cars, you turn left and go right, that's what you have to do. It's just kind of difficult at first, but then once you get in the hang of it, it's just easy. But yeah, turn left, you turn right, you know, still to do. Also, another thing I didn't explain, I'll show you in my next aircraft we push out. It's a tow bar, the circular tow bar, and then the pushback vehicle. First starting out, when you're pushing, if that tow bar is not already connected to the metal or on the front end of the metal, it's going to jerk the plane a little bit. It's really not going to do too much unless you just slam on the gas, and that can like jerk the plane, and then the pods may get a little bit antsy. You may get the passengers a little whiplash up. But yeah, and then when you're slowing down, you want to make that the stop very gradually, not forcefully, because you will jerk the whole plane at that point, especially if you're on a slope a little bit, because on this right here, with a slight slope, you can't really see, but it's a slope, but like one plane maybe on a 180 degree angle, and the other side may be 176. So it will feel the jerk throughout the whole plane. Throughout the plane, I have seen a couple times where the whole plane just shook and probably a small accident. I don't know. And also there's a shear pin that controls, like, so you don't mess up the landing gear, the front and the end of the plane, and you don't mess up the tow bar, and you don't mess up the pushback vehicle, that shear pin will pop. It'll almost sound like a gun shooting. It's very loud. If had one time where it popped, and the passenger was like, I could see the passengers looking out the window, like, what's going on? Especially if it's a first time flyer or someone that doesn't fly that often, they can get a little bit nervous at times. You just want to make the experience smooth and as comfortable as possible. So we're gonna watch this plane take off, and then we're gonna go to work our next plane, which is gonna be a 717. And also, it depends on the length of the plane, how wide it is. So yeah. You say they can't leave till they have the numbers. We got 1 minute out.
Just waiting for the pilot to say he can confirm the number. I guess he just follows the rules to the team.
Start, Captain.
Alright, brake set.
Alright, thank you.
Thank you.